The first number one misconception regarding Islam, the top of the charts, is regarding jihad. Today, jihad is the most misunderstood word regarding Islam. It is not only misunderstood by the non-Muslims, it is even misunderstood by many of us Muslims. Non-Muslims and many Muslims think that jihad means any war fought by any Muslim for any reason, whether it be for power, whether it be for wealth, whether it be for land, whether it be for language, any war fought by any Muslim for any reason is called as jihad. Jihad does not mean any war fought by any Muslim for any reason, whether it be for money, whether it be for power, whether it be for land, whether it be for language. Jihad is an Arabic word which comes from the word jahada, which means to strive, which means to struggle. So jihad basically means to strive and struggle. In the Islamic context, jihad means to strive and struggle against one's own evil inclinations. Jihad also means to strive and struggle to make the society better. Jihad also means to fight against oppression. Jihad also means to fight in self-defense in the battlefield. So jihad basically means to strive and struggle. For example, if a student is striving and struggling to pass in the examination, in Arabic, we say the student is doing jihad. He's striving and struggling. Many people have a misconception and they think that jihad can only be done by a Muslim. There are many verses in the Quran which say that even non-Muslim did jihad. Quran says in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 14, we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. In travail upon travail the mother bore you, and in pain did she give you birth. Immediately after praising the parents, especially the mother, the verse continues. Surah Luqman, chapter 31, verse number 15 says that, but if your parents do jihad, strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides Almighty God, of whom you have no knowledge, then don't obey them. But yet, live with them with love and companionship. Here the Quran is talking about non-Muslim parents doing jihad, striving and struggling to make their children do shirk, worship somebody else besides Allah. A similar message is given in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 8, that we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. But if their parents do jihad, they strive and struggle to make you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, besides Almighty God, then don't obey them. So here the Quran is talking about non-Muslim parents doing jihad. And there are various such examples of Quran mentioning non-Muslims doing jihad. Now this type of jihad, in Arabic, we say jihad fi sabil shaitan, jihad in the way of the Satan. What we Muslims should do is jihad fi sabilillah, jihad in the way of Allah. And whenever the word is mentioned individually about jihad, in the Islamic context, it is understood it is jihad fi sabilillah. Most of the non-Muslims, including many so-called Muslim scholars, inverted commas, they translate jihad as the holy war. Holy war, if you translate in Arabic, it means harbu muqaddasa. If you read the Quran, if you read the hadith, there is no Quranic verse, there is no hadith which uses the word harbu muqaddasa. The word holy war doesn't exist in the Quran, neither in the hadith. Jihad, as I mentioned, basically means to strive and struggle. And one type of jihad is also fighting in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is qital in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But jihad doesn't basically mean a war. One type of jihad, there are various jihad for nafs, one type of jihad is fighting in self-defense in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we see the history of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first 13 years of his prophethood that he lived in Makkah, there were many Quranic verses that were revealed, all the Makkan surahs. Many a time in these verses, the word jihad was used. And never did the Muslims ever fight, physically fight. Only when they migrated to Medina, then the wars took place. But yet you find the word jihad in several verses of the Quran which were revealed in Makkah. Many examples I can give you. For example, Quran says in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 69, that those who do jihad in the way of Allah, those who strive in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we open up the pathways for them. When the verse was revealed, there was no war at that time. Quran says in Surah Furqan, chapter number 25, verse number 52, that do not follow the unbelievers, but do jihad against them, strive against them strenuously with the Quran. That means you do jihad with the Quran. Jihad with the Quran means strive to convey the message of Allah. Do you think you're going to fight with the Quran? So here we realize that this misconception regarding the word jihad, it is depending how the media portrays. This word jihad wasn't a problem a couple of decades earlier. After 9/11, it came on top of the charts, number one. Previously, it wasn't there. So depending how the media portrays Islam, these misconceptions arise in the minds of the non-Muslims. For more details on jihad, you can see my lecture, my talk, Terrorism and Jihad, an Islamic Perspective.